This fellowship is unique because of the people. We have a terrific, diverse group of faculty and fellows. We're blessed with getting some of what I consider to be the best fellows in the country, frankly.
Our goal here is to build and form leaders. What I look for fellows is a growth mindset, people who are not afraid of taking a challenge, and also people who are team players.
When I came here for my interview, I just felt like the people here were just so, so nice. And it definitely felt like a very collegial environment where I knew what was important to me is that I wanted to get a lot of experience. I wanted to see a lot of different patients. One of my passions is health disparities, and I definitely wanted to make sure that I was taking care of people that look like me, in addition to taking care of others. And then I also wanted the exposure to be able to do things like research and things of that nature.
Probably our biggest strength is how well that we mesh, both the fellows and the faculty, you know, and the support staff. And, you know, you'll see that.
I think it's just a very friendly, warm environment, and it's pretty vibrant.
This is a great fellowship for both clinical training and research. We have a diverse experiences for clinical training. We train across 4 hospitals, the VA, Eskenazi, University, and Methodist, and so you get a little different flavor for how care can be provided, and that provides some versatility to fellows as they move forward.
You know, the first year of fellowship is really clinically heavy. You're learning to be a pulmonary and critical care physician, and we do a really good job at that. The hard part about fellowship is that I can turn you into a great pulmonary and critical care physician, but I need you to help drive the process of where you want to go in the end so that we can create a fellowship experience that will get you there.
I think I describe it as a place for growth. That's the only way that I can encompass the level of warmth that is present here, but at the same time, the challenge you have to rise to.
Your fellowship experience in the first year is amazing. You learn so much, and you are really seen as the frontline provider and the pulmonary critical care specialist by both our colleagues in internal medicine, urology, and other specialties, and you're also seen as the leading provider by your patients. They're seen as people who deliver amazing care at the bedside, and it really is a confidence booster.
With that, you have so much experience with procedures and handling different scenarios that by the time you're 6 months into your first year of fellowship, you're pretty much ready to handle just about anything. Some of the things that people worry about, you know, are they going to get enough intubations, bronchoscopies, chest tubes? I mean, a lot of those things you're going to be comfortable with within the first 6 months.
Naturally, the first year coming out of residency and into, you know, basically a faculty position as a fellow, it is a change. And you see a lot of maturity in those years as well.
We've had fellows who have gotten master's degrees in clinical research during their fellowship. We have had people work on their master's in public health. We've got a clinical educator track of people who have interests in that. So the program can be flexible enough that no matter where you ultimately want to end up, chances are really good we can create a track, a pathway to get you there.
You get the best of pretty much everything here. The best in terms of seeing different difficult cases, procedures is really important, mentorship, research. So I'm very happy with my decision.